Now, I want to see our relationship with Russia normalized, functional, and productive. There are so many urgent priorities in the world that need Russia and the United States moving forward as partners. And respect for human rights is central to this partnership.
The farce of the trial of Sergei Magnitsky shows how far the regime is willing to go to protect itself. It is also proof of the fact that what we have done with the recommendations in the European Parliament and with the legislation in the US Congress has already an effect, has already results.
Recently adopted bill says that we as foreign agents, or as Lyudmila says, agents of foreign governments, should register ourselves as spies if we get foreign granting, foreign finances, as well as we do political activities or influence public opinion.
Правозащитные организации в России, к сожалению, существуют в основном на средства из-за рубежа.
Unfortunately, human rights NGOs in Russia are financed with the with foreign donations, foreign funding from abroad.
We want the Magnitsky standards to be global. It shouldn't just apply to one country, it should apply globally. And we want other countries to follow the lead of the United States as it relates to those that were responsible for the tragedy against Mr. Magnitsky, particularly our friends in Europe.
The question is how the West can respond, in which way. I'm very happy and I congratulate the United States of America that they adopted the Magnitsky Act. And I personally hope that Europe will follow to do something similar, to use the targeted sanctions against those people who are violating human rights, who are violating the basic freedoms, or who are involved in corruption, and who are involved in bringing the black money to the European Union.
In three words, what the West, how the West should respond, and in particular the European Union. After all, Russia is a neighbor of ours on our continent. And these words are vigilance, candor, and conditionality.
Don't isolate neither our civil society Russia nor the Kremlin Russia. Even during the times of the Cold War, the Soviet Union and the West found areas for cooperation. But cooperating on energy security, on nuclear, or whatever, regional security, don't pretend that this is strategic partnership or cooperation, because strategic dialogue is possible only on one basis, on the basis of convergence of values.
On the other hand, we also see the legislative changes that are aimed at the very same goals of further reducing the freedoms of my fellow citizens of Russia.